أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I welcome you all to this week's lesson. And inshallah, we shall continue with our revision lesson. And we are going to look at the section B, part of section B of our syllabus. And those areas are what you are seeing on the screen, which has to do with agricultural ecology. Under it, we have rock formation, soil formation and profile development, environmental factor affecting crop and animal distribution and production. So, some question has been carved out from these areas I have mentioned, which we shall look at now. And these are some of them. So, question one says, the process whereby rocks are broken down to small particles through both physical and chemical factors is known as dash. This area where the question comes out from has to do with rock, and in particular weathering of rock. And that process whereby rocks are broken down into tiny soil particles is known as weathering. So that makes the correct answer here be option D, which is weathering. Second question. The parent material of a soil is formed from the disintegration of dash A, sand, B, gravel, C, rock, D, organic matter. So parent material are only formed from disintegration of a rock particle, and that makes option C the correct answer. And that is what I have said earlier, that weathering of rock has to do with the breaking down of this rock mass into fine soil particle. So we go ahead to question 3. Question 3 says, the cross section of a sediment of soil showing the horizon or layer is known as dash. This is coming from the topic on soil profile. And definition of a soil profile, if we remember, is that is a vertical a cut whereby a vertical section is made into the soil, which reveal different layers of the soil. And this layer are what we call the horizon. And we have horizon A to D. Horizon A, which is the topsoil. Horizon B, which is the subsoil. Horizon C, which is the parent material. And horizon D is the bedded rock. And these are the arrangement of the soil when we make vertical cut into the soil. And doing this is what referred to as the soil profile. So the correct option here, that cross section of sediment of soil showing the horizons or layer, is the profile, which is talking about the soil profile. Question 4. The major factors influencing the physical or mechanical breakdown of rock into fine particles include the following. This is still talking about weathering of rock. Weathering of rock, there are some factors responsible for rock weathering. We have the physical factor, we have the biotic factor, and we have the chemical factor. And these are what we call the physical weathering, chemical weathering, or the biological weathering. So the physical weathering and the biological weathering can be put together in one in the form this question I've stated it, which is talking about the physical and chemical breakdown, merging both the climatic factor and the biotic factor or the biological weathering together. And these options, we have A, man is physical. We can see that how man contributes to the breaking down of rock particles to form soil. B, animal, the browsing nation of animal inside the cracks or holes created in the rocks will also lead to rock disintegration, or the penetration of plant roots into the rock mass will also expand it and lead to the breaking down of the rock mass. Wind, the carrying of small pebbles, heating or colliding with this rock mass gradually it will also lead to the breaking down of the rock to form soil. And this, from my explanation, we can see they are both physical and mechanical. We can see how these rocks are being disintegrated to form soil particles. The last one is solution, is a chemical agent. We cannot physically see how the whole process is being carried out. And that's why the only one out of this is that option D. So to the next question. Question 5. Edaphic factors which affect agricultural production include the following, except the nature of this type of question, we did revise it in the last lesson. Remember I said factors affecting agricultural production are broken down into three major categories. And we have the biotic factor, the climatic factor, and the edaphic factor. And those edaphic factors is always what we call soil factors. Those factors that affect soil one way or the other are referred to as edaphic factor. And the following are edaphic factors, except one of them, and that will be temperature. Temperature is a climatic factor. All other options there are all soil factors. So before we go ahead, let's go back and see question 6. Rocks are classified based on A, age, mineral component, C, mode of formation, D, structure. Rocks are classified into three based on their mode of formation. How are these rocks formed? And that's what gives us those three classifications, what we call the igneous rock, the sedimentary rock, and the metamorphic rock. So we go ahead now to question 7. Soil profile is important in agriculture because it's dash when we reveal different layer of the soil, of what importance it is. Option A says determines the soil cardinal, no. B determines the type of land tenure system, has nothing to do with land ownership. C gives indication of the type of crops to grow. And this will be the correct option, because when we reveal the different layer, there are different level of nutrients as this layer goes down, and that will be the correct answer to this particular question. D, promote the weathering of rock, is out of it. 8. An alkaline soil can be found mainly in dash area. This question is coming from our soil classification, where we classify soil into three classes, what we call the zona, the intrazona, and azona soil. The intrazona, there are so many factors that lead to the categories of this soil into these three classes. And the first one, the zona soil, the factor responsible here is usually the vegetation of that area or the climatic factor responsible for it. And that's why it is also broken down to what we call the pedophase and the pedocast. So to the second one, which is the intrazonal soil, as a result of poor drainage resulting to water logging and leading to accumulation of salt material, and that's why we have that, the second classification, what we call the intrazonal soil, which is subdivided into what we call hydromorphic, when there is excess water in the soil, when what we have holomorphic, when it has a lot of salt in it, and what we call calcimorphic, when it has a lot of lime content, high lime content in it. And the third one, which has to do with the azona soil classification, which is also based on the nature of the topography and the soil profile. Here we have them subdivided into what we call the little soil, the rugose soil, and the alluvial soil. So this question comes out from that second class of soil, which is what we call the intrazonal soil. And the one that is subdivided where this question is coming from is that of the holomorphic type of soil where there is a lot of high salt content in it. And where we find this type of soil is usually in a very dry area, and the only place that will be dry in this option is the arid area. So fresh water swamp that is still water, Guinea savanna, places of water not as dry as the arid region, and mangrove scarce water content. So A is our correct answer to this particular question. So we'll go on to the next one. When sedimentary rock are formed from the remains of animal like corals, they are called dash rock. Still has to do with rock. We are one of the type of rock which is the sedimentary rock. Sedimentary rock are formed through three means, whether physical means, that is what we call physical or mechanically formed sedimentary rock. We have the biologically formed sedimentary rock, and we have the chemically formed sedimentary rock. This question is on the biologically formed sedimentary rock. If this rock sediments are formed, accumulate together, sediment together to form a solid mass, we refer to as sedimentary rock, and they are coming from the remains of plants and animal, we refer to them as biologically formed sedimentary rock. If they are formed from the remains of plants, they are known as carbonaceous sedimentary rock. And if they are formed from the remains of animal, they are called calcareous sedimentary rock. And these corals are from the animal remains. So the correct option here will be calcareous rock, because it is formed from the remains of an animal. Question 10. Which of the following is not an example of mechanically formed sedimentary rock? Now, with this option, we have clay, we have coal, we have conglomerates, and we have the sandstone. All other options except coal are the example of physically formed sedimentary rock. The coal is not a physically formed sedimentary rock. To the next question. Factor of soil formation include the following, except that some factor is responsible for formation of soil from a rock mass. Climate is one of it. That's why we said we have a climatic weathering. Parent material, soil profile, time. Except soil profile, all other options listed there are factors responsible for soil formation. Question 12. Changes in the form of pre-existing rock is due to the action of the following, except a change rock is what we call metamorphic rock, and there are some actions that take place on this, either the igneous rock or sedimentary rock, before it gives rise to what we call metamorphic rock. And all the option listed here will be responsible except acid, and that makes acid the correct option here. Compaction will be responsible to change either igneous rock or sedimentary rock to a metamorphic rock, heat or the magma. To question 13. The biotic factor which derive much benefit from livestock and reduce productivity is a dash. Coming from the area of those factors responsible for crop and animal distribution, and something like this also feature in our last class. The biotic factor are the living factor that affects both plant and animal production and distribution, and those biotic factors, that a particular one of them which will now derive benefit from the host and reduce its productivity is parasites. Parasites are organisms that live on the body surface of animals. They derive their benefit by sucking their blood and causing a lot of economic damage to the livestock animals, and that's why we refer to them as Parasite. Question 14. During chemical rock wedging, the equation below represents which of these type of chemical wedging. We can see that the iron oxide is reacting with water here, and the result we are having is still the iron oxide with attachment of water molecule. This type of chemical reactions with this equation is what we call hydration. If you remember, there are so many types of chemical wedging. Let's begin from the options we have here. We have carbonation. If it has to be with carbonation, instead of water reacting here, it will be carbon 4 oxide reacting with the rock mineral. If it is hydrolysis, it means that the water is going to react, not only attach to the resulting mineral that will be formed. And if it is oxidation, oxygen is going to react with the rock mineral to lead to the breaking down of the rock mass to form soil particle. And the one that doesn't feature here is what we call solution, when the rock mineral is being dissolved in a solvent to lead to the breaking down of the rock mass to form soil particle. And those are the different types of chemical wedging that we have. I'll take it again. We have the solution, we have the oxidation, we have hydrolysis, we have hydration, and we have carbonation reaction. To the next question. Question 15. The typical A horizon of a soil profile contains mostly dash. As I've said earlier, those soil profile will reveal different layers of the soil, and there are four layers in all. What we call horizon A, horizon B, horizon C, horizon D, which I've earlier stated. A is the topsoil. Horizon B is the subsoil, the C is the parent material, and D is the bedded rock. This question is now asking, the typical A horizon of a soil profile contains mostly dash, A clay, B decaying organic matter, C gravel, D mineral. It will contain decaying organic matter because topsoil is made up of decaying organic matter. 16. Which of the following is a stratified rock? A sedimentary rock is known to be a stratified rock because the sediments accumulate together in layers and then solidified together. And that's why we said they have a line or a bedding line, or what we call they occur in strata. Among this example given below, the one that occur in that layer is chalet, which is option D. The basalt, the gabbro, the granite, they are all example of igneous rock, except that option D, which is the correct one. So question 17. Igneous rock formed within the earth crust are called dash. Igneous rock, as we remember, are formed from the eruption of molten magma, which solidify and cools down over a long period of time to form a solid mass referred to as the igneous rock. And there are two types of igneous rock. We have the plutonic rock and the volcanic igneous rock. If they are formed within the earth's crust, they are referred to as plutonic igneous rock, and if they are formed on the surface of the earth's crust, they are referred to as volcanic igneous rock. So the correct option here is a plutonic igneous rock. Going to question 18. The two main elements of climate which affect soil formation are dash A, rainfall and temperature, B, rainfall and air, C, temperature and light, D, wind and relative humidity. The two climatic elements in which their action are very well pronounced is the option A, rainfall and the temperature, which is the correct answer to this question. 19. The major role played by parent materials in the soil formation is that they dash A. Let's take the option A, affect the rate of runoff and erosion, B, determine the chemical composition of the soil, C, determine the rate of soil percolation, D, influence soil microbial population. This question is asking us about of what importance does the parent material play in this soil formation. Different rocks are made up of different chemical constituents, and the parent material are derived from this rock and which determine their chemical composition. So the correct answer to this particular question is that the role it plays, that it determines the chemical composition of the soil that is formed from that particular type of rock. Question 20. The application of heat and pressure change coal to dash. We have seen that one of the previous questions, that we have a change rock due to some factors. And as we have seen then, heat and pressure is one of those factor acting on pre-existing rock, which could be igneous rock or sedimentary rock, and they will be changed to another form of rock when those factors act upon them. An example of a change rock that we have here is the application change coal. The question I have picked specifically coal. It will change coal to what we call graphite. Coal will change to graphite as a metamorphic rock. And we have come to the end of our revision exercise as relate to section B of our syllabus. Inshallah, we'll go through the remaining parts of the content we have in that, under that particular section. And I will implore you to try as much as possible to go into your assignment portal and practice with those questions that you have there, so as to boost our recall ability of what we have done in the previous years. May Allah make it is easy for each and every one of you and spare our life till the next class. I wish all of you a fulfilling Eid al-Hadia festival. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.